everybody. Okay, welding helmets. You are not going to weld any better than you can see. If you can't see what you're doing, you're not going to do that good of a job. Now, I know I'm not a consummate pro when it comes to welding. Some of my stuff needs a little work here, but you know what? It holds together, and I'm happy with it on that front, and I am striving to improve my welding. And one of the things I vowed to do, I had been struggling with this helmet here for a while, and you know what? I don't like it. Can't see half the time. I saw this one here. The reviews were a little mixed on it. The only pick I have about this helmet is the headband. It's okay. Every welding helmet I've had, they're a little wonky at times. The headband, being able to lock it up and snap your head down and have it go down. I've had some mixed success on this here. Looks like they tried here on this welding helmet here. This is the Yes Welder Welding Helmet Pro M800H, okay? The user's manual to me isn't that good. The one thing that was lacking that didn't spell it out just absolutely clear for me was the settings on this thing here. So we've got weld, we've got cut, we've got grind. You've got the 5 through 9, you've got the 9 through 13. For most MIG welding and flux core welding, you're going to want 10 or 11, I would say. So you'll put it on the weld and then go ahead and adjust it here between 10 and 11. If you're going to be doing TIG welding and the like on thin metals, you might even want to bring it down to a 9 or maybe even just a little bit below. You've got your delay. I put this thing here on the minimum delay. That way it comes on quick. And then the sensitivity here, I put it on the most sensitive. Sometimes if you're outside or you've got a bright light coming against you, it may darken before you're ready to weld. So that's what these adjustments here will be handy for you here. So I figured out the 9 through 13 is on the weld setting. Then the 5 through 9 is on the cut setting in the middle. I just kind of had to play with that and figured that out. With when I'm playing with my TIG welder on low amperage settings, I need it a little bit lighter than 10. Normally I run 10 on my MIG here. But once I got that figured out, I'm good to go. Ultimately what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to swap out the headband here with my old one here, and I'll be good to go. I don't think I'll have any problems. It's almost a 4-inch, 3.96 by 3.64, I think is what they say, a viewing area here. It gives me plenty of room. I can see. If you want to do good weld, you need a good welding helmet. This thing here runs about $70 when I bought it. Be sure and get you a good pair of safety glasses, whether you need them or not, as far as any magnification goes. You want a cup around your eyes. I've had sparks fly, hit my shirt, hit the inside of the welding helmet, and go towards my face. I don't want to pick red hot metal out of my eye hole. I know you don't want to either, so get you a pair of safety glasses. I'll put the links down below for the welding helmet and the safety glasses. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. If you like my videos, give me a thumbs up. Click that subscribe button down there. And hey, for those of you who are doing motorized bicycles, I think I'm going to do a how to weld up your own gas tank. A lot of people like to play with that. So that's coming soon here. I'll have details about that. But stay tuned for that. Take care.